Who doesn't like the sound of rain? How's it going, guys? We're all here, and welcome to Rain. It's a game I've started a long time ago playing by myself, and I haven't been able to actually play any more of it for quite a while. So I just thought, you know what, let's start over from the beginning, because I pretty much forgot what was going on, so might as well just start all over. Let's begin, shall we? Alright, let's see. Alright. If he had not become... Ah, I missed it. Perhaps he still would have been there. Lower the volume a bit. He would have gone to the circus if not for the fever. Little Nemo? That just made me think of Little Nemo. Because that was the plot for the last one, too. Or at least the movie. And then the rain began. Along with it appeared a girl. Their eyes met. At the time, he had not understood what those eyes were trying to tell him. The girl was not the only thing that appeared amid the raindrops. Slender Man. We'll close the window on that. Yep, well, good luck. The shadowy form seemed to be chasing the girl. The boy rushed off in the rain to pursue them. And as he turned a corner, there he saw it. The door of light leading off into the darkness. So now we're talking about Kingdom Hearts. The two shapes passed through it. And the boy followed after them. Though, through into the night. I always get those two words mixed up, so apologies. Also, if you're wondering why Ant isn't here, it's because we have completely different jobs, completely different hours, and it's really hard for us both to be in the same room at the same time. The rain was falling endlessly on the town, beating down between the buildings, soaking the streets, and revealing the shape that the boy had lost. So yeah, I'm invisible. Don't know why. Game never explained it, at least as far as I played it, so we'll find out together. It was standing in the middle of the street. It seemed to be searching for the girl. The unknown turned towards him, but the boy was nowhere to be seen. The roof protected him from the rain and hid him from sight. The unknown went back to searching for the girl. Timidly, he held out his hand. His hand began to appear in the midst of the rain. It was then that he realized he too was invisible. Suddenly there was a sound among the raindrops. Two pairs of eyes sought out its source. The boy began running. He had to save her. Why? No, I'm serious about that one. Like, there was no real reason for him to want to try to save her for anything. Why was he there? Why was he invisible? Even the game's asking the questions. He had to find the answers. He had to find a girl. Perhaps she would have the answers. He began to and so began the tale of two, a tale only seen in the rain. Chapter 1, The Children and the Night. So yeah, this is sort of like a semi-stealth platformer game. So, let us begin. I believe I said that already. my commentary has gone to shit. Oh jeez, I wonder how to do it. The girl's silhouette has melted away. Had melted away. Only the boy remained alone in the night. I kind of like this style of telling the tale using that. I'm not going to read that because that's not plot. Oh, let me guess. It's going to spell out rain in big letters. Huh? Small letters. Literally, small letters. The places where the rain did not reach would be where he would disappear entirely. Until I bump into stuff. Ooh, piano music. Love me some piano music. Let me guess, once I bump into, yeah. Alright, so I can semi see myself through my walk cycle. And of course, just bumping into random things. To escape the uncertainty of being invisible, he needed to find rain, but if he could see himself, it meant others can see him too. Salmon. The gate before him was bent out of shape. The boy did not have the strength to open it. I think the game kind of fourth wall broke right there. That the boy cannot see himself if he's not in the rain. Because I'm pretty sure if you're in first person, you don't really need to see where you're going. You have an idea. Oh, shit. You have an idea of where you are spatially. Up, time to run. Okay, the boy ran as fast as his legs could carry him to a place where he could disappear. For a moment, the rain fell silent, and his pursuers disappeared into the night. So yeah, again, it's a stealth, semi-stealth thing. Can I? Okay, I know where to go now. The door broke open, so that's where I need to go. Hey, look, it's that girl. So yeah, I was saying, the game semi-broke fourth wall logic. Because even you can't see yourself, you still have an idea of where you are. Sure, you can't see your hands, but again, you have an idea. I don't know, maybe I'm just... I guess I really can't say because I haven't been invisible. Oh, and they could go into the thing too. The girl disappeared down the road ahead. Only the boy and the beasts remained. He had to get past them without being seen. That's a good thing there's a big-ass bridge here. Okay, I guess that's not where I'm going. Okay, I see where I'm going. Oh, fuck. Okay, it was just a cutscene. I thought I got busted. He could see a roof, safety, but it was a long way off. He would have to run for it. Oh, fuck. Did I fuck up? Nope. Alright. Go, 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 go. Oh, fuck. This is a long run. Okay, I'm good. He had come to associate invisibility with safety, but... Okay, now the game's gonna tell me. Out of the downpour, they vanished into nothingness. Only the sounds of their footprints remain. Footsteps, my bad. So yeah, again, they're invisible, I'm indivisible. But I can see their footprints. His way forward was blocked by the beast. By a beast. The beast might seem as if it might react to a loud sound, loud enough to drown out the rain. Okay. So use puddles to make sound. Got it. Time to climb. Jump. Yes, I can. Oh, fuck! The beasts were crushed to death by falling scaffolding. Good for them. Alright, there's the girl again. Where am I? Oh, fuck! Literally right in the open. Alright, gotta make it over there, but let's make some noise over here. Shit. Ah, fuck! I lost track of him. Alright, let's try this again. Hide in the shadows. Noise over there. Carefully walk past that, because that was noise. You know what? Maybe I'll have to make some noise here too. Nope, 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 nope. That was a bad idea. There we go. Supposed to go when his back is turned, not the other way around. Suddenly, he saw her again. Yo, what up? When a girl appeared, she was not alone. The moon lit up the stairs. Oh, stairs. Stairs or stars? Not sure. Examine. The scaffolding under him toward him, preventing him from reaching this. Okay. Oh, fuck. I'm the one. There we go. Oh, it killed him too. Alright, I get it. I need to lure them over here so I can get the scaffolding done. It's over here. Nothing. Okay. He found a beast lurking at the end of the alleyway. Okay, I guess that's not gonna work. Fuck, I lost him. There he is. Ow. I lost myself in there too. Oh shit. Okay. I'm good. Over here. Over here. Oh god, there's a run. There he is. Good boy. Where's this lead to? He's to dead end again. Yeah, this game has a that stealth mechanic thing. I'm not really a stealth guy, but this is simple enough for me. I could never beat any of the Metal Gears. Chapter 1, Children of the Night. Finn. Alright, chapter 1 done. Let's go on to chapter 2, I guess. This rain just doesn't stop, does it? Oh no, it's Big Armed Man again. And this time I'm caught in the open. Time to book it! Chapter 2, Raindrops and Footsteps. You can't find me. Oh, fuck me! All you can do is run away from the fearsome footsteps. You know what, maybe I should walk past those. I should just keep running. Hold the run button. Oh, fuck, he's gonna catch me! Oh. As far as fast as I can carry him. Oh, fuck! Ah! I didn't know what I was gonna do there. Okay, back to running. I'm pretty sure there was a hole or something I just couldn't crawl through. Because that's obviously a dead end over there. Wait a second, he's not tall enough for that to hit him. Okay, yeah, it was a crawl space. I couldn't tell. I couldn't see from the way the game was. Alright, time to go, because apparently you can't break that down. What's with all the boarded up streets? And then he saw them. Tiny footprints. Oh no. The girl cried out with all her might. The boy screamed momentarily. But their voices could not make a sound. The words blew away like wind, like the leaves in the wind. Damn, I wish they would leave me alone for that long. Oh, nice one, dipshit. You didn't close the door for... Oh, fuck. Ah! I'm a dipshit. Okay. That was dumb of me. I should have waited. Oh, I can't skip this. Or can I? Okay, yeah, I can. I didn't realize it would close that fast on me, though. Alright, where am I? Okay, there I am. Alright. The boy had saved the girl. But the girl had not seen him. He became visible each time he stepped in the muddy puddle, even when it rained out. Okay, yeah, so my stuff is gone for whenever I get in rain. All he needed to do was walk in watery puddle and he would return the way he was, so yeah. The game is pretty much telling me, don't step in water, or the dirty water. Step in the normal, nice, clean one, or else they'll wreck you. And there goes my phone. God, I am so happy to be a professional. The boy returned to the town. But there was no sign of anybody there, and it seemed like it had been that way for some time. So to be fair, the town would probably be empty. I mean, this rain is crazy. It's just constant. Aw, damn. I thought I can sit on the table again. Alright, let's see what happens. Uh-oh. Big, tall, and meanie. Time to hide. Luckily, the lumbering monstrosity had not seemed to have noticed him yet. Yet. He came to a curious little phonograph. Oh, fuck! I didn't expect you to come out of there. Run, 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 run. Ah! Bitch! Did you just give the peace sign? How was I supposed to outrun him? Now the game gives me the distance I needed. Now I'm visible too, so there's no point of even trying. I would just fall into the damn water at this point. The puddle will get me nice and clean again. Oh well, that's just me. Yeah, because you know that makes sense. He emerged from the water, washed clean of mud. He had reached a church. Good. You know, that's salvation right there. chapter's going on a little longer than the last one, isn't it? Is that the girl? Let me guess, if I go up to it, it's locked. Yeah. Not surprising. You had to find a way around. How the hell is it raining in a He finally got out. As I was saying, how the hell did he get up? Is it raining in the church? I was dumb. Had to leave the room carrying the key would give himself away. Oh, right. You know, the moving leaves wouldn't give me away, would it? Jumped out there and hit me. Oh, that was a... What was I supposed to do there? Okay, I obviously have to play this. Do I just stay hidden? I do. Okay, he just goes out there himself. Go, quit fucking around. That's a big fucking key. Ah, see? Smart. That's what I am. Time to get the fuck out of here. Search as he might, he could not see no sign of the girl. Only the church yard stretching off before him, and beyond it, the abandoned factory. Time to make my way downtown. Walking fast. Ah, chapter 2. Raindrops and footsteps. And forgot really how far I've gotten into this game, because I obviously forgot how to do that puzzle, but yeah, live, see la vie, live, and learn and learn. I think I screwed up somewhere around there. See what this opening is about, and then I'll call it. Spoopy. You know, I've always wondered, how come a factory is abandoned? And what happens to it? Chapter 3, Separation. As if we weren't separated before. Alrighty, we'll end it right here. Thank you guys for watching. Hope you guys enjoyed. Yeah, I'm replaying an old game that I've played before, but I never got to finish. Because I guess I never really just sat down and tried playing it through again. But now you guys get to enjoy the experience with me. And you know what, let's just keep the thing on pause and let the beautiful music play. So expect this series to keep going with interruptions of galore. Stay golden, everyone. And cue the happy music.